Okay. Yeah. My name is Mati Shmueloff. My full name is Matityahu Shmueloff. I'm an Israeli writer now living in Berlin. Today I see myself as a Jewish writer because I will never live again. I think in the near future in Israel, and I'm living in Berlin, and I have a daughter and a family. What Galut means for me? Galut for me, it's the existential situation of a Jew, because my parents are, my mother's family is Babylonian Jews, and my father's families are Syrian and Persian Jews. And their stories is stories of exclusion from the Arab world. And then when we were immigrated to Israel, we also were in a galut there because we never really, they never really recognized our culture and heritage, and even destroyed part of the heritage. And for instance, for 12 years in my education system, I never learned nothing about the Babylonian Jews. So think about it, how much damage they did to my identity. It took me years to teach myself as an autodidact and to go to university to learn about it. And now when I'm living in Berlin, it feels like a third galut, as I take the term from the artist Joseph Semach. And there is a book about Iraqi writers saying from Exile to Exile of Nancy Berg, when she examined Samir Nakash and Shama Michael's writing. And I feel it's like another exile. And it's not like a political exile because I can go back to Israel, but it's a political exile because I cannot go back to the Arab countries I immigrated from, and I cannot even examine my roots as, for instance, European Jews can examine their roots here in Europe. But it's deeper than that. I think it's we realize that both the Christian world and the Islamic world are they have a problem accepting the Jewish world and its values in the old monotheistic worlds. But nevertheless, in my little private world, I don't feel it in a. I feel I have very much accepted both my Christian friends and my Arab friends. It's not that it's more a political and theological being to be in a galut, and less personal. It's personal maybe in my dialogue with God and with my inner self, to my heritage and to my state of being, living in a limbo because I cannot vote or participate in German life, and I cannot vote in Israel, and my writing is not fully accepted in Germany and not fully accepted in Israel. Also in Israel it's been further galut, because for them to hear Jews from outside of Israel talking freely, it's a problem. They want us to be all Zionists, and I'm not. It's from the morning I wake up. I mean, it's you have to be very. You walk very, very like a cat in the street. You feel like whether I put a kippah or not. Whether I have to think about what. All the relation between Israeli and the media, and then people who hate Israel, and I try to go between and try to, with my writing, with my project, to I try to do best as I can to find bridges to this abyss. For instance, I have a project in Berlin which Arab Jews who came from Arabic states meeting Arabs in a literary and musical exchange, and we had a great event doing that. And before that I had a group here called Poetic Hafla which did the Middle Eastern and readings in different languages all throughout Berlin. We did 17 meetings and parties. And in Israel I also tried to overcome the state of galut by talking about the Mizrahi issue, talking about my personal heritage, writing about it, articles, poems, open ads in the newspaper. Sometimes it's also made me damage because the one who clothes out, the one who's doing. Let's do it one minute. Stop for 1 minute, please.